Populated the earth after the flood. So you are a descendant of Noah. And not only that, you're made in the image of Seth. Adam was made in the image of God, before, you know. But then we're made in the likeness of Seth, his son. To my understanding, and I could do a little bit more homework on that too. So why is it hard for people to be honest, you think? Why do people lie, do you know? There's a reason why people lie. I don't think we need any more cement. Don't want to come up short. And you go into eternity, you can't go into eternity without Christ, or you will be up short. You'll come short. As he's already said. He's already said. All have come short of the glory of God. I'm a little tired, guys. What is it? It'll come to me. All have fallen short and come short of the glory of God. I don't know the verse. But you can Google it. It's there. King James Version, guys. The NIV is a perversion. We might find some truth in there, but for the most part, your King James is your most reliable, is the Word of God. Not most reliable, it is the Word of God. creep this one more time. It looks pretty level to the one next to it. A lot of water on this one, guys, so some of that has to evaporate off. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That's it. But there's none righteous, no, not one. The only one righteous is the Lord Jesus Christ. And you need his righteousness, and the only way you can get it is by trusting his blood, believing Paul's gospel. Once you do that, God the Holy Spirit baptizes you into God. Into the death, burial, and resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. You don't have to go get a water baptism. It's based on your belief. Whether you believe or you don't. Thank you, Lord. Actually, the Star of David on the so-called Star of David, on the flag of Israel's flag, it's really the Star of Moloch, Star of Rimfran. You can check it out, just Google it. But that is not the proper emblem for Israel. It shouldn't be. You know who Molech is, right? Go do your homework. In Acts chapter 7, I believe it is. In the same passage that Stephen gets stoned. The Star of Molech, or the Star of Rimfran, is mentioned there. That's that Star of Rimfran. Check it out. Do your homework. It's in Wikipedia too, I think. So the real Israel of God will be called by God himself. You heard the term in the New Testament called the little flock? That's the true Israel of God. What you see out there today is developed by the United Nations, not by God. That nation out there today was not put there by God. That nation out there today was put together by the United Nations. The true Israel of God will believe that the Lord Jesus Christ is their Messiah. And for the most part, Israel has rejected the Lord Jesus Christ as their Messiah. I know it was Netanyahu who came and spoke to Congress a couple years ago. And he mentioned Abraham and Isaac and a few other notables in the Bible. He failed to mention the Lord Jesus Christ. And there's a reason why he didn't mention them in his speech. I think it was in 2012 or 13 to our U.S. Congress. So there's a reason why he doesn't mention the Lord Jesus Christ. Because that, I don't know, maybe he doesn't believe the Lord Jesus Christ is his Messiah. Or God Almighty, because the Lord Jesus Christ is God Almighty. In flesh. 100% God and 100% man. Nobody else like him on the face of the earth, ever, in all human history. And you will give an account to him. And if you're short, you will go to hell in the lake of fire forever. Short meaning you're not complete in Christ, you're done. Forever. In a worm's body. You don't get a resurrected, glorified body. You'll get a worm. What did Christ say on the cross? He took your worm. You know that, right? Matthew chapter 9, verse 44, I think, or Mark 9, 44, I think it is. Or 9, I think it's 9, 44. I am a worm and not a man. It says it in Psalm 22 also. I am a worm and not a man. That's what the Lord Jesus Christ said on the cross. He took your worm that you deserve for all eternity. A worm doesn't have hands, doesn't have a head, doesn't have legs, doesn't have eyes to see, can't hug, it can't kiss, nothing like that. A worm is a worm. And if you're not in the Lord Jesus Christ when you die and you go to hell, that's what you're going to get. Probably thinking, now how do I get saved, right? Believe Paul's gospel. Trust the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's the only thing that's going to save you is the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. His blood is what pays for all your sin for all eternity. It's by grace you are saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it's a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. I implore you, relinquish your good works to get into heaven, because it's not going to get you there. Christ did the work for you. He's the faithful Son. He's the only one righteous. There's none righteous. That means President Obama, that means Queen Elizabeth, there's none righteous. No, not one. King of Saudi Arabia, you name it. There's none righteous. When Christ says there's none righteous, guess what? There's none righteous. Looks like chili con carne, guys. Oh boy, this is a lot of work. I'd like to take a little water break. See, when I drip the sweat hits the cement, and I gotta redo the stuff. That's because I got a lot of water in it. Those pros, guys, they know what they're doing, man. I'm a beginner, okay? No doubt about that, I'm a beginner. Oh boy, I hope I'm not too shy there. Girls, ladies. So that bolt stripped, huh, guys? I've got one more inside, so I'll have to put that on. Hopefully that'll fix it. I gotta take that drum off. I'm not laying anymore. Well, I think it's best to take the machine back. Because it failed just off of that. I mean, it shouldn't. I mean, this is only what, there's 20, 40. This is roughly almost 60 bags of concrete that's already fallen apart. That's not a good product. I've been told that a lot of companies will build failure into the parts and into the product. So it fails quicker and you have to replace it sooner. So you got to spend more money instead of saving that extra money and getting out of debt or whatever.
number one, don't borrow money. Rule number two, don't forget rule number one. Terrific lightning storm yesterday. Some big voltage going down. Yeah, I think it's Satan's cast down like a lightning bolt. Boom. He didn't have access to the third heaven to my knowledge. He's in the second heaven and has access to the earth. Those heavens out there are unclean in his sight, in God's sight. They're unclean. As beautiful as this earth is, and as beautiful as the stars are at night, they're still unclean in God's sight. God is holy. He's without sin. You and I, we have sin. It's in our flesh. This comes out all right. I mean, we can do all the research and thinking, and eventually it boils down to hitting the road, you know, getting it done. What is it? In all labor there is profit, but that's it. The talk of the lips leads to penury, which is extreme poverty. God wants us to work. He designed us to work. And to invest. Cast your bread on the waters, and many days you'll find it hits. Remember the parable of the talents, right? He gave one man one man five talents, one man two talents, another man one talent. And when I had five, when I made five more. When I had two, when I made two more. I think I'm saying that right. And the one who had one went out and made... Oh, he didn't make any, did he? He was ashamed of his one talent, and he buried it in the ground. He buried it in the ground. And when the Lord came back, and it was time to reckon, you know, the guy who had five, you know, he got 10. He says, well done, good and faithful servant, enter the joy of the Lord. The one who had two, I think it was, he said, well done, good and faithful servant. It doesn't say son, it says servant. Well done, good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of the Lord. See, he'd made two more. So he made 100% return on his two talents that he received from the Lord to begin with. The guy who had five talents, he made 100% return also for his master, for his Lord. But the guy who had one, he buried his talent. And he was ashamed of it. But when it came time for reckoning, he said, "What is it?" I'm not quoting it just right, and I should have the scripture with me, but I'll try to summarize it in layman's terms. I think the Lord calls him a wicked servant. And that you know that I'm a harsh master or a hard master. You know where I reap where I have not sown, or I can't remember the word, but where I have not strawed. Something like that. And he said you should have at least have given the one talent to the money changers, right? The money exchangers. So that I would have least returned, I would at least have received the interest, right? Interest is the last. So what I'm saying is you got to invest. I mean, in any economy, in any time, you have to invest. There's good companies out there, ones that are good, and there's bad companies out there. Things that are morally wrong. I mean, if you're going to buy a company that's it might be performing abortions, I wouldn't buy that company. They might be making tons of money, But in the end, when you got to give an account, I said, Scott, you went and bought a stock that that invests in abortion equipment? I mean, that's not a good thing. So, yeah, it's there's good products and there's bad products. Okay. So. Investing our time in Scripture is most important. That's where you get the greatest return. I, wisdom, dwell with prudence. They dwell together, you know, wisdom and prudence. It's almost like they're married, right? Isn't a married couple, don't they dwell together? Well, wisdom dwells with prudence. And what is prudence? Better yet, why is prudence, right? It says what? The prudent man foresees the evil and hides himself, but the simple pass on and are punished. You need to hide in Christ, guys. So a prudent man is going to hide in Christ, right? Where a simple man is going to pass on and be punished. And that's with everlasting destruction, guys. You don't want everlasting destruction, man. For the sinner, this life is the best it's ever going to get. For the saint, this is the worst it will ever be. So get into Christ and get to be a saint. Now you got to realize what gospel saves, too, guys. We live in a period of time called the dispensation of the grace of God. There was a dispensation given to the Apostle Paul. And the gospel that is for all of humanity today to get saved is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 3 and 4. Believe Paul's gospel. He calls it my gospel. There's a reason why he says my gospel. Because there's another gospel of the kingdom, which is meant for the nation of Israel under the law. And 95% or 99% of the churches in America and around the world preach the gospel of the kingdom. Repent, be baptized for the remission of sins. See, in the dispensation of the grace of God, all your sins are forgiven. They're not remitted. They're all forgiven. I need a perfect Savior. I need one that can forgive all of my sins. Because I got a lot of them, believe me. And so do you. Says he who says he has no sin deceives himself, and the truth is not in him.
guys. Shit's get some fireworks tomorrow, huh? Just be careful with those things, man. Make sure you don't shoot your skyrockets on top of someone's roof. You ever thought why these rock and roll bands worship Satan? There's a reason why. And why so many people are just drawn to their music. There's a reason why. You know, bands like, what are they? Def Leppard and, oh man, Metallica, Ozzy Osbourne, all that crap. It's just crap. And you got these Miley Cyruses and all that junk. It's just junk. It's garbage. But man, people flock to that stuff like... flies to you know what. Those pros, man, hats off to them, man. They know how to do it. I don't. I'm learning, though. I'm learning. Good old Steve. Man, that guy, he did this his whole life. That's amazing. There's some incredible people out there. They're very skilled in what they do. Hey, don't butcher me too much on the responses there on the video, please. I know a lot of you guys aren't gonna like what I said and all that kind of stuff, but I mean, we're all entitled, I guess, our own perspective. That's volition, free will. In the United States, we have freedom of speech, but sometimes I wonder about that. At least they say we have freedom of speech. If you say something that's contrary to the masses, you're not gonna have that much freedom of speech. Anyway, moving along here. Thanks for your patience, guys. In a bit, I'll show you what I've got going. Hopefully you can see it all right. And I'll show you the deal there. Well, I might as well do it now. Excuse the bumpy ride here. I'll try to be gentle. This is what we just laid, trying to get that floated out. Got the plastic along the vigas there. Put this plastic along the stucco wall. I mean, if I didn't put that plastic on, all that other stuff would be all over the wall. This is my wheelbarrow. This is the cement mixer. That's what I got left in it. See, I took that bolt out of there. That was holding it to this thing back here. See, here's the bolt here. Just stripped. And this is what happened. This little pin here sits in that little groove there. And it bent. It looks like it, I don't know if it goes one way or if that's just the way, yeah, that's the only way it goes. So, and it, when that, this bolt got stripped, that came loose and popped off of that thing with the load in there. So, that's what we're dealing with on this thing. I would have mixed more cement, but I'm not going to try it with it. I got to take it back. These are my vigas here. Let me put you guys back on the stand, all right? I can bring it over here and you guys can watch the troweling if you'd like. Because that's really all that's left now at this point. Because I'm not going to add any more cement at this time. So I'll tilt the camera down. There you go. And I'll just let it run out. HelpersOfYourJoy.com, great website. And also Pastor Tom Druche on YouTube. And Bible Divider, Eric Newman, Richard Jordan, Les Feldick. A couple good books is Satan's Plan of Evil by K.R. Blades. You can get his book at a reasonable price on enjoythebible.com. Excellent book, a must read. Then another one my friend gave me, fellow saint, Frank in Wisconsin, The Seven Mysteries of God. I don't know who the author is, and I'm still trying to get through the King James Bible in 1 year, and it's hard to do, guys. It is hard to do. I mean, it's not hard to do. I just need to have my priorities straight. And sometimes I don't. Oh, man. You know, Satan was a cherub before he fell. His name was Lucifer. He was the anointed cherub that covereth. He was above the throne of God. The Lord Jesus Christ created him. Do you know that? And he sinned, he fell when iniquity was found in him. Remember, if you read the Genesis account, you'll see that after Adam and Eve were cast out of the garden, you know, the garden east of Eden, looks like you got a little bit of cement on your face there. Anyway, after Adam was cast out of the garden, there was cherubs that were guarding the way back into the garden with flaming swords swinging every which way. And the cherub, I don't know if you know this, has four faces. You can read about it in Ezekiel. Four faces, these guys. One of a lion, one of an ox, one of an eagle, and one of a man. And these are real living creatures in heaven, in the third heaven right now today. There's a city there too called the New Jerusalem. It's in the third heaven today. It's a real place. And that's where the Lord Jesus Christ is right now, on the right hand of God the Father. See, Paul the Apostle,
when he was stoned at Lystra, he was drug out for dead, left for dead. He had an out-of-body experience, basically. And he was taken to the third heaven. I think it's in 1 Corinthians 12. You can read about it there. He was taken to the third heaven. It's not the New Jerusalem. Third heaven is different than the New Jerusalem. The New Jerusalem is a city in the third heaven. Just like Dallas is a city in Texas. Or I should say San Antonio is a city in Texas.
Nothing against Dallas. I'm partial to San Antonio. Because the best preacher on the planet came from that city. Pros are probably laughing at me. Like, why don't you have a bull float? Because I have no money. My rib likes to pop out periodically. Float. 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 Off to those guys who do this for a living. Amazing. And they do it to support their families. It says a man who does not provide for his family is worse than an infidel. That's a non-believer, guys. Someone who's not faithful. Infidel. Not faithful. Infidel. Fidel is faithful. You know, the Marines, Semper Fi. Always faithful, remember? I should let it sit a little while. Let that water, see, it looks like it's a little high on this side and low on that side. So when the water drains, I want it going away from the house. Thank you.
prudent man foresees the evil and hides himself. Oh, man. See how the color difference? I don't know if you can see this one over here. This one's more of a pinky color. That's a brownish color.
Rust color. Float. You just want it to float across the top. See, I got this plastic in here. Damn it. Excuse my language. Shit. I better get that out now before that becomes problematic. Again, the prudent man foresees the evil and hides himself. I see the plastic's there. I better pull it out or I'm gonna have a mess later on. Damn. I did want the plastic over the vigas, but I don't want it intertwined with the... I won't do that. That's where the... I know I'm gonna get graded on this. The pros are gonna go, what are you doing, dude? That's the thing with being a beginner. Hopefully they're a little compassionate. It's a little runny there. I need to clean this trowel again. Nice sense. So I need the plastic there, but I don't want it getting mixed in too much with the cement. So I need to have that barrier.
You know, all these stories about the earth ending and all this kind of stuff, the big meteor that's going to hit it and all that stuff. After the catching away of the saints, you know there's a 7-year tribulation period that's going to be on this earth. So if someone tells you the earth is going to end next week, they're lying. Actually, it says in Ecclesiastes chapter 4, the earth abides forever. Also, did you know the earth does not rotate on an axis? And it's called geocentric. The earth does not rotate around the sun either. Think about that, guys. We've been lied to. And the reason why is because Satan is the god of this world. And he doesn't want us to see the truth of God's creation. He knows. He knows what the truth is. He knows what God's done. He doesn't want you to know, though. He doesn't want you to know that you can be saved forever and rule and reign and participate in God's plan called glory forever.
It's still soupy, guys. I gotta let it air out a little bit, dry a little bit, but I want it to be semi-level before it does, so that it's, you know, like patterns like that. I don't want big, huge globs in one area. I want it uniform, if I can get it uniform. See how it's like soupy? A little nick there or something, huh? Bring some of that up here. Fill that hole. I know my mesh was getting a little close to the surface over here in this area. Level. You're probably getting bored of watching, huh? I think you guys have probably seen enough, so I'll turn the camera off. I hope you guys have a great week. Remember, trust the blood of Christ, guys. You don't need to go to hell. Heaven is totally free. Heaven is totally free. It's been paid for by the blood of Christ for you forever.